You are watching DHTV from California State University, Dominguez Hills.
Okay, in this segment, we will conclude the class. So students, let's appreciate the human response to adversity. The United States must own up to its history of hate and violence. For the Chicano, the experience of the 19th century U.S. policy towards Mexicans and Native peoples is all too familiar, and it can still be felt today. We must understand how a society can come to learn to hate. No child is born a racist. No child is born a sexist. It is a learned experience, and we must come to terms with the past. Now, it's one of the reasons why we offer courses like this. Now, there is a matter of Mexico being occupied by the French. After all the struggles to keep Mexican nation afloat, Mexicans are now going to have to deal with the French coming in to take over their country. Mexico was a very vulnerable country in the 19th century. It was experienced tremendous violence. Mexicans in the 19th century will not know peace. There's Mexican independence. There's the Alamo. There's the Texas question. And then Mexico is going to be invaded by two very powerful nations. One is the United States, and the other will be France. Napoleon III invaded Mexico while the United States was preoccupied with the Civil War. And let's appreciate a film clip from the History Channel, and let's listen to their contemporary spin or their alternative interpretation of Cinco de Mayo.
Cinco de Mayo, or the 5th of May in English, is a celebration of Mexican heritage. Over the years, many people have come to believe that it marks the day of Mexico's independence, and that's, well, just wrong. The 19th century was particularly brutal for Mexico. After a bloody struggle to win its independence from Spain in 1821, the fledgling country fought America from 1846 to 1848, and then a civil war beginning in 1857. These conflicts left Mexico's economy ruined and its army exhausted. The nation had accumulated war debt and just couldn't repay its European backers. Mexican President Benito Juarez declared a 2-year suspension on its loans. That news didn't sit well with England, Spain, and France. So in 1861, those nations planned an invasion, but France wasn't out for just reimbursement. Napoleon III wanted to overthrow the Mexican government and install a French monarch in the Western Hemisphere. When England and Spain realized France's true intent, they withdrew support. Napoleon believed that Mexico was too weak to defend itself against his superior military. In 1862, over 6,000 French troops landed at Veracruz and headed toward Mexico City. But a surprise was waiting. Mexican General Ignacio Zaragoza and a few thousand militiamen waited behind fortified walls in the city of Puebla. The French marched into town on the 5th of May. The outnumbered Mexicans opened fire, killing 1,000 French troops. After a 2-hour battle, the remaining French retreated. Word of the victory spread throughout Mexico, and Zaragoza became a national hero. Later that year, the city of Puebla was renamed Puebla de Zaragoza, and Cinco de Mayo was decreed a national holiday. But Napoleon wasn't celebrating. Upon hearing of his army's defeat, he sent 30,000 more troops to Mexico. Within a year, the Mexican army was crushed, and Napoleon installed his Austrian cousin, Archduke Maximilian, as the nation's leader. Maximilian's rule was shaky from the start. Most Mexicans were still emboldened by the Cinco de Mayo victory and celebrated the holiday with songs and dance while under French occupation. Mexico's future president, Porfirio Diaz, led an uprising in 1867 that finally overthrew the French army. Maximilian was shot and killed. His bullet-riddled shirt is still on display in Mexico City. Cinco de Mayo had become Mexico's rallying cry. People remembered it with feasts, mariachi music, dancing, and picnics. The celebration continues today, both north and south of the border. In fact, commercial interests in the United States have made Cinco de Mayo very festive, even though many people aren't aware that the holiday is a tribute to General Zaragoza and his nation's resistance against foreign domination.
Okay, so that's Cinco de Mayo. Now, Benito Pablo Juarez Garcia, Benito Juarez, was Zapotec from Oaxaca. He's the first indigenous person ever to serve as president of Mexico, first indigenous person ever to lead a country in the Western Hemisphere. He resisted the French occupation. He overthrew the empire. He restored Mexico, and he introduced land reform efforts in order to help the poor. Now, Benito Juarez's liberal efforts to modernize the country challenged the conservative elements that sought a continuation of the old colonial system of casta privileges. Today, Benito Juarez is remembered as being a progressive reformer dedicated to democracy, a progressive reformer dedicated to equal rights for his native, indigenous, and Afro-Mestizo populations, dedicated to lessening the political influence of the Roman Catholic Church that held over Mexico, and dedicated to defending national sovereignty. The period of his leadership in Mexico is known as La Reforma, the Reform, and his rule actually implemented for the first time the independence agendas of Hidalgo, Morelos, and Guerrero. Now, one of the reasons why Cinco de Mayo is celebrated in the United States more than it is in Mexico is because Cinco de Mayo became a rallying cry for justice for the Chicano movement in the 1960s and 1970s. In the civil rights movement for Chicanos in the 1960s and 70s, Cinco de Mayo became that day to commemorate a resistance to an occupation. So the Chicano movement revived Cinco de Mayo celebrations in the United States. And the idea was to resist the occupation of the United States on Mexico. Cinco de Mayo was a resistance, an understanding of a resistance to an occupation. And the French in this case, the United States in the United States. Now, this was very important because it was a political event in the Chicano community, and that's why Cinco de Mayo is celebrated in the Chicano community. This was all the way true up until the 1980s when there was a reaction to Chicano studies, when there was a reaction to Chicano history, and then, of course, Budweiser, and then eventually Corona beers, and now Dos Equis took over the celebration. But one of the reasons Cinco de Mayo is celebrated in the United States is to remind Chicanos and Mexicanos and Central Americans and Latin Americans and Caribbean Americans of the commitment to liberation that Juarez engendered amongst the population. Cinco de Mayo is an event that all Latinos, Mexicans especially, Chicanos, should commemorate, all people of color. We must commit ourselves to the struggle for human rights and dignity. Benito Juarez insists that we stay vigilant of our rights. Entre los individuos, como entre las naciones, el respeto al derecho ajeno es la paz, meaning that amongst individuals, as among nations, respect for the rights of others is peace. It is inscribed on the coat of arms of Oaxaca. In this course, we give honor to Benito Juarez's vigilance. We must continue to resist the occupation and resist the racialization process. Thank you much for enrolling in this course.